This is a prototype wingsuit, and it's one of the ones that I'm testing out for the wingsuit landing project.
The wingsuit landing project is Jeb Corliss's attempt to be the first person to ever jump from an aircraft and land, not with a parachute, but using a wingsuit, a high-performance bodysuit inspired by another of Mother Nature's extreme athletes.
The easiest gripe is like a flying squirrel. So you can imagine you've got wings between your arms, wings between your legs, and as you're flying, instead of falling straight down, you move forward 3 feet for every foot you fall. So it can give you a glide angle. So you're no longer flying straight towards the ground, you're actually flying on a slope.
Wingsuits have been around for years, but landing with one has always required additional equipment.
The attempt is going to be to jump from an aircraft, reach terminal velocity, and then land without using a parachute. The hard part is to survive uninjured, because that's the goal.
Though Jeb wants to avoid injury, he's not averse to bodily risk.
When I was a really small child, I used to enjoy catching rattlesnakes. And then when I turned 16, I got really into diving with sharks. Sharks petrified me, so I started diving with sharks. And then shortly after I got back from an 8-month-long trip diving with sharks, I saw base jumping for the first time. And I remember the first time I saw it thinking, ha, well, there you go. That's my future.
Jeb has jumped from the Seattle Space Needle, Venezuela's Angel Falls, the Eiffel Tower, and the Golden Gate Bridge. But a jump off the Empire State Building was halted by security, and he is in a civil suit with the building's owners. Today, Jeb is performing a series of wingsuit training jumps. He must practice with a parachute for the day he can attempt the wingsuit-only landing.
I've been challenging myself since birth. I mean, that's what I do. It's always been about, I don't want to say overcoming, but learning to control fear.
For the actual wingsuit landing, Jeb will jump out of a helicopter half a mile above the earth and need to hit a 20 by 20 foot gateway, the entry point of his custom-built runway. Precision wingsuit flying is vital.
For me, important things is how well I can control the suit. That's very important for me. I need to be accurate with it. And then it'd be really nice if I can get it to fly slow. The slower it flies, the better the landing will be.
Details of the design of this landing structure are top secret. He's not the only contender obsessed with making history. Around the world, other wingsuit pilots are devising their own strategies for making the first non-parachute landing.
Right now, it's all about training. I have 1,000 wingsuit flights out of planes and several hundred off cliffs, so now it's more about what I'm doing with them. People ask me, what's the point? Why would you want to do something like that? And I mean, to be honest with you, for me, the wingsuit landing is something that, people have never done before. And it's hard in this day and age to do something that's never been done before. I mean, this will be the first time that a human being has reached terminal velocity and landed on their face at over 110 miles an hour and gotten up and done it again. That's a very special thing. And as far as I'm concerned, this is something people have wanted to do since the time of Icarus.
All Jeb needs now is funding, about $2 million to build the runway. The rest will be history.
Everyone thinks this is so impossible, you can't do that. I mean, well, the only reason why you think it can't be done is because you haven't done it. I believe I can, and that's probably why I'm going to.
And what's the plan for the rest of the day?
Plan for the rest of the day is to keep practicing and training and jumping. I'm going to be jumping all day long.